दिस इज प्रशांत. टुडे आई एम गोइंग टू स्टार्ट विथ वर्क एनर्जी एंड पावर पार्ट बी. नाउ जस्ट चेक. नाउ व्हेन वी से वर्क, नाउ वर्क डन, इट इज अ डॉट प्रोडक्ट ऑफ टू वेक्टर्स. वन इज फोर्स एंड सेकेंड इज डिस्प्लेसमेंट. वर्क इज अ डॉट प्रोडक्ट ऑफ टू वेक्टर क्वांटिटीज. वन इज फोर्स एंड सेकेंड इज डिस्प्लेसमेंट. Now, this is written as Fs cos theta. Now, my question is, why this cos theta? Now, in standard 11th, we have definition of dot product. Now, what is the definition of dot products is, you have two vectors, A bar dot B bar. These are two vectors. Now, dot or scalar product of two vectors is defined as product of magnitude of two vectors and cosine of the angle between them. Cosine of the angle between them. So, here also, this is my one vector, which is force. This is my one vector force. This is my another vector, which is a displacement. And angle between them is theta. Angle between them is theta. Now, next part, I will split or I will resolve this vector into two components. I will split the component of S bar along F bar as S cos theta. S cos theta is a component of displacement in the direction of force. Similarly, I will split F bar into two components. Out of that, one component will be along S. That is called as F cos theta. So, F bar along F bar, there is a S cos theta. And along S bar, it is F cos theta. Right? Now, how to write this part? W is equal to, this is F into S cos theta. Or I can write this is equal to F cos theta into S. Now, what is F over here? It is a force. What is S cos theta? Is the component of displacement. It is a component of displacement in the direction of force. In the direction of what? Force. It is a component of what? Displacement. Where? In the direction of force. Similarly, what is F cos theta? F cos theta is the component of force in the direction of displacement. In the direction of displacement. And what is S? It is only displacement. And this is what? Displacement. Right? So finally, what you have to remember, the work done depends on three factors. One is magnitude of force, magnitude of displacement, and cosine of the angle between the two vectors, force and displacement. Now friends, this is the only part which is something different. Right, now we'll go for different special cases. Now in special cases, I'm writing here, these are the special cases. First case, I'm writing here, if theta is equal to zero. Now what do you mean by theta zero? My force and displacement, say this is my body. This is placed on this platform. I am applying force to this body. This is the direction of force. This body is displaced in the same direction. So here the angle between force and displacement will be zero. So I can write here, therefore, this is W is equal to Fs cos zero. But our cos zero comes out to be 1. So I can write W is equal to Fs, right? Now this is nothing but condition for maximum work done. This is the condition for what? Maximum work done. Work done is maximum when theta is 0. Work done is maximum when theta is what? 0. Right? This is very important part. Now, what are the example for this? Example for this is what? Any body which is kept on the platform and you apply force to it, if that body is moving in the direction of force, then their theta will be 0 and cos 0 equal to 1. Now we'll go with different cases, that is case 2. Now just check what is case 2. Case 2 is very important. Frequently asked question will be based on case 2. Now check what is case 2. In case 2, if theta is equal to 90 degree. Now what is cos 90? Cos 90 will be 0. Now take an example. This is a pulley, right? This is a pulley carrying a load on his head. This is a load. This pulley is moving along the horizontal direction, horizontal surface, smooth road, right? And this will be the force of gravity, F. So the angle between force and displacement is what? 90. Angle between force and displacement is what? 90. So W is equal to Fs cos 90. But what is cos 90? Cos 90 is taken as 0. So your work done, W is equal to 0. Right? Now this is a case of minimum work done. This is a case of what? Minimum work done. Minimum work done is 0. Theta is 90 degree. There is one more example for this. This is our Earth and this is a satellite which is revolving around it. Now this satellite, I'm drawing this satellite. This satellite is revolving around the Earth, right? So the angle between, this is a force called a centripetal force. This is your displacement, which is S. The angle between force and displacement is 90. Angle between what? Force and displacement is 90. Therefore, work done will be 0. Right? Now the question is, if the satellite is only performing half circle, then also work done will be 0. Right? Because the body is revolving, the force acting is centripetal and displacement is 90 degrees. There is one more case over here. If body is moving in a circular path, displacement is also 0. But this is not applicable for all parts. Because if I take only semicircular part, work done will be only 0. There is no displacement 0, but still work done will be 0. Now we'll go with third case. Again, third case is different. Now if theta is 180 degree. Now what is cos 180? Cos 180 degree is minus 1. Cos 180 is what? Minus 1. Now take an example for this. This is a body, right? This body, the force of gravity will be F is equal to mg. But I am throwing this body against gravity, so this is my displacement. So angle between force and displacement is what? This body is not taken, it is thrown against gravity. So your work done will be negative. Now suppose this is a platform. On this platform I am placing a box. This is the box. I am applying force to this box in the right direction. So this is the direction of applied force. Now this is the direction of applied force. Body is displacing in this direction. This is the displacement of body. But this is the frictional force. This is what? frictional force. Now this frictional force is opposing its motion. So the angle between frictional force and displacement is again 180 degree. So work done against friction, work done against gravity will be negative work done. So here I am writing this part, W is equal to Fs into minus 1. This is equal to minus Fs. This is called as negative work done. This is called as what? Negative work done, right? So there are three cases: when theta equal to 0, work done maximum, theta is 90, work done is minimum, and theta is 180, it is called as negative work done. It is called negative work done, right? We'll go with the next part now. Now next part is about SI unit. What is SI unit of work? Now work done, W is equal to F into S, right? Now work done is a scalar quantity. Work done is which quantity? Scalar quantity. Scalar means it has only magnitude. Now here I am writing SI unit. Force will be Newton. Displacement is in meter. So this Newton meter is written as joule. Joule mein J small. It is joule. If you are writing it pura word, that is J small. CGS unit is erg, ERG. How it is related? 1 joule is equal to 10 raised to 7 erg. 1 joule is equal to how much? 10 raised to 7 erg. Right? Now how? What is the relation between SI and CGS unit of work? So we have work done W is equal to F into S. So work done is said to be 1 joule when force of 1 newton produces a displacement of 1 meter. Now 1 newton is written as 10 raised to 5 dyne and 1 meter is 10 raised to 2 centimeter. So this comes out to be 10 raised to 7 dyne centimeter. This dyne centimeter is written as, or this is one part, 1 joule is equal to 10 raised to 7 or. Now this is the part. Now next part will be energy. Next part will be what? Energy. Now what is energy? Energy is nothing but it is a capacity of a body to do work. What is energy? It is a capacity of a body to do work. So we can say therefore work and energy is same. So for us what? Work and energy both are same. Right? How they are same? Take a body. Take a body. This is the platform. I'm taking this body from here to certain height. Right? I'm taking this body from here to certain height. Now I'm doing work. I'm doing work to lift this body from here to here. So that work done is stored over here in the form of potential energy. So work and energy will be same. Now if you drop this body from here to down, the potential energy decreases and kinetic energy will increase. So that is the law of conservation of energy. Total energy remains same. So from that we can write work and energy is same. Now SI unit of energy is also same. SI unit of energy is again joule. CGS is erg. How they are related? Exactly same. 1 joule is equal to 10 raised to 7 erg. Now we'll go with the next topic, which is called as power. There is a term called as power. Now what is power? Check. Now power is nothing but rate of doing work. What is power? It is the rate of doing work. So when we say rate, that means it is divided by time. So I can write here therefore power is equal to work upon time. Power is equal to work upon time. So power depends on two factors. One is the work done and second is the time. Now, what will be SI unit of power? SI unit will be joule per second, which is written as joule, second raised to minus 1, or it is written as watt, capital W, or W-A-T-T. This is what, right? Now, this is the one part. Now, there is a relation between your force, that is power, force, and velocity. Check the relation between power, force, and velocity. Now, what is power? Power is work upon time. Now, instead of work, I am writing force into displacement upon time. Now, what is the displacement upon time? Is nothing but velocity. So I can write this is equal to F into V. So finally you got power is equal to force into velocity. Power is equal to force into velocity. This is the part. Now, what is the SI unit of power? Is written as what? Right? Now we'll go with the different units of work, energy and power. Different units of work, energy and power. Check that part. So we write here different units of work, energy and power. Now first unit is EV. E stand for electron volt. Now this electron volt is the energy of atomic particle. But the very small energy is expressed in terms of electron volt. Right? The one EV equal to 1.6 into 10 raised to minus 19 joule. One EV is how much? 1.6 into 10 raised to minus 19 joule. Now, to convert from electron volt to joule, I want to convert from electron volt to joule. Multiply by 1.6 into 10 raised to minus 19 joule. Now, to convert from your joule to electron volt, it is divided by same number, 1.6 into 10 raised to minus 19 joule. This is the second. This is your first. Second part is kilowatt hour. Now this kilowatt hour is nothing but commercial unit of electrical energy. What is kilowatt hour? It is a commercial unit of electrical energy. Now what is 1 kilowatt hour? Is 1 kilowatt into 1 hour. Now what is 1 kilowatt? Kilowatt is 10 raised to 3. Watt matlab joule per second. And 1 hour matlab it is 3600 second. Second cancel. So this comes out to be 3.6 into 10 raised to 6 joule. Which is written as 3.6 mega joule. But when we write mega, it should be capital M. This is mega joule. Mega is capital M. Right? Next part is again watt hour, right? 1 watt hour is 1 watt into 1 hour. 1 watt is 1 joule per second into 3600 second. Second cancel. So this is 3.6 into 10 raised to 3 joule, which is 3.6 kilo joule. Now this is second movement. Now we'll go for the next one. We'll go for next one. Now what is next? It is nothing but your calorie. Third is nothing but calorie. Now this calorie is a unit of heat. Energy, food energy. Energy value of food is expressed in terms of calorie. Now one calorie is actual value is 4.186 joule. Which is approximately written as 4.2 joule. This is one part. Then you have, next is horsepower, HP. In mechanical engineering, power of a machine or an engine is expressed as HP. 1 horsepower is equal to 746 watt. 1 HP is equal to 746 watt. Now, there is a last part of this topic. There is a differentiate between work and energy. I will just discuss with the points work, and here it is power, not energy. It is power. First point of differentiate is your definition. In both the cases, first point is a definition. In physics, first point of differentiate is always a definition. Second point you can write is SI unit. Second point is SI unit. And third point, it depend. So this is work is independent of time, but this power depend on time. So these are the three points of distinguish, right? So friends, that's it for this video. If you like my content, please do subscribe and share this video with your friends. I will be coming with the work energy power part B, part C, along with numericals step by step. Thank you so much. Bye.